Hey, are you currently using REST APIs for communication between your applications and microservices? You know, things like post and get and delete and put. Did you know that Solace has a couple different ways of interacting with REST-based applications? Do you want to see a really cool way of having a REST client talk to a publish-subscribe application using topics? Hi, I'm Aaron from Solace, and today I'm going to walk you through a tutorial on how to event-enable your REST applications. Okay, so point your browser to codelabs.solace.dev, which is where you're gonna find all of our various self-guided Solace code labs, such as how to build a battleship game using Spring Cloud Streams and JavaScript, how to integrate with a Raspberry Pi, and this one, how to event enable your REST architecture. Now this tutorial uses a feature of Solace called the Micro Gateway, which allows the Solace Event Broker to communicate and interact with REST-based applications, essentially allowing a native bridge between the kind of blocking, synchronous, request response world of REST into the more asynchronous, event-driven architecture world of publish subscribe. Now, this tutorial is divided into three parts. We assume that you're going to have some REST clients, like your laptop, sending REST requests to some backend service. We're going to use Postman Echo for this, but if you already have a microservice or a database or something to respond to REST requests, that's great, you can use that. Part A, we're going to go and create or configure the Solace broker to allow the incoming REST request and to log that. Part B, we're going to configure the kind of the back end or the outbound side of the broker to allow it to pass that REST request through to the back end REST service and then the response back, essentially turning the Solace broker into a pass through or a proxy. And then part C is where things get interesting, where we build a Java application that's going to use publish subscribe to essentially wiretap the request response flow as it goes through the broker, and then actually respond to the REST request itself, thereby eliminating the need to have that backend REST server, which allows this true mashup of kind of REST in and publish subscribe out. So under the prerequisites section, you'll see everything you need to run this particular tutorial. The main one being a Solace broker. This could be either a Docker desktop running on your laptop. This could be a free Solace cloud instance. This could be a Solace hardware device if you're running this on-prem. Details for all of these are down here. You're gonna need curl or Postman or something to inject REST requests. And then you're gonna probably need a Solace API, Java API, JMS, JavaScript, whatever, to be able to build that messaging application to provide the kind of backend service in part C. Now, one of the cool things about this tutorial is that when you configure the Solace broker, there's multiple ways of doing it, right? You can either use the GUI tool, the PubSub Plus Manager, but we also have a RESTful Management API called SEMP. Everything that you can do with the GUI tool, you can also do with SEMP. And we also have a command line interface. So Solace, if you're a big shell user, you really like terminals, we have a fully configurable command line interface where you can log in and do all of your command and configuration. And this tutorial, like each section, each step where you walk through the configuration, we provide all three different ways of doing that. So if you don't know SEMP that well, or you want to learn CLI, you can kind of just follow along and do it. So for example, part A, section A here, when we start to configure the REST port, there's some screenshots here of like how to do it with the GUI tool. Then if you want to use SEMP, I provide the kind of the HTTP request and the response, where to look for it in the response. And at the bottom here, if you want to learn CLI, how to run the commands in CLI. So you can basically, you only need to do one way when you're doing the configuration, but you can, they're all three different ways are provided here. So I'm not going to walk through this entire tutorial. That's what a self-guided tutorial is actually for. So head over yourself to codelabs.solace.dev and check it out there. You'll see that it says, there's 60 minutes for this whole thing. A colleague of mine did this thing in less than half an hour, so maybe I was a little overzealous with how long each section took. But all in all, it's pretty quick, and you should be able to kind of get this thing up and running fairly easily. So one other place that you should check for more information on the Solace Micro Gateway is our documentation portal. Head over to docs.solace.com. Simply type in Micro Gateway. You'll see use cases and examples and all sorts of other ways of configuring and using the Solace Micro Gateway feature with your REST messaging applications and Solace. So the Micro Gateway allows your REST applications to do request reply to your publish subscribe applications, or the other way around. But Solace also has a RESTful Messaging API, which allows your REST applications to post directly onto topics or directly onto queues and have those messages also posted out of the broker to a particular URL, kind of like a webhook. For more information on this, I'll just put it all in the description down below. Go check that out for all the references. Please like this video if you enjoyed it. Subscribe to our channel, and thanks a lot. See you next time.